Yesterday, I think I had 26 Krama Brahmacharya applications. I roughly counted, it came to 26. Still, I have to finally give them all the instructions, what not, and everything. Krama Brahmacharya is nothing but following all the rules of the same as sannyas. Only thing, till you complete your education, you will be going to your college and studying with same kavi. With same kavi color dress. And all the outer symbols of sannyas. That's a pride, understand? That shows Brahmanyam Bahubutratam. My life is going to be different. I am coming here just to learn, so that I have to, when I serve, I enrich people. So I have some questions on Krama Brahmacharya. Is it possible to have some idea on what is involved in Krama Brahmacharya and sannyas? As I said, already I said, you are literally living as sannyasi. See, one more thing, somebody is asking, is it that I declare that I want it and then the process is shared, or can we know what is involved so I can say that I can commit to it or not? No, first we will tell you what all is involved, then you can declare. Basically, I have no idea what is involved, so not able to choose. Okay, please listen. Somebody asked me, what is the age limit for Krama Brahmacharya? You can ask for Krama Brahmacharya only till the marriage. If you are already married, you cannot ask for Krama Brahmacharya. If you are married and divorced, you can ask for sannyas. That will be given only if you are complete with all the outer world and ready to settle with the sangha. And if you are married, still living in marriage, you can ask for rishi order. That both have to ask with the kids. Whole family to ask, only then the rishi order will be given. That also you should be able to settle with the sangha. So your kids should be able to settle with Gurukul. All that, I think I have clarified the doubts. Any other doubts means, send the questions, I'll answer. If the parents are asking, if the children get the Krama Brahmacharya, can they go out on vacation and all that? They can go out anywhere as my sannyasi only. You see, somebody asked me a question. If somebody in their family dies, can the kids do all the rituals, Shraddha and all? Can the children do the Shraddha? No. You will not be able to do Shraddha as a son or a grandson or the part of the family member. You can only be able to attend as sannyasi, my representative. Like if a devotee dies, how you go and bless, give the Swami's presence and blessings and come back. Only that can be done. You can only chant the Shanti Mantra, Shwasti Mantra and come back. You will not be able to do rituals. So make it very clear. Clear? Because literally you follow all the rules of sannyas. So parents have to be clear. Even for vacation, they may come as my representatives to grace the house because you are a devotee for a few days. It is literally like giving a son or a daughter to become a sannyasi or sannyasini. Understand? But without Krama Brahmacharya also, they can be part of the Gurukul. Gurukul is not only for the kids who have taken Krama Brahmacharya. Krama Brahmacharya is one extra facility available in our Gurukul. But I tell you, the kids who take the Krama Brahmacharya and take up the sannyas have the best profile and resume in future. Chosen by the greatest incarnation at the age of 4, personally trained and initiated into sannyas at the age of 5, groomed to become a world teacher, and now going around the world and sharing the great enlightenment science and the experience of enlightenment with the world. Understand the meaning of this resume? then I tell you, after that, none of you oldies guys, people will come and sit and listen to you guys. They will ask, what age you have been chosen and trained by Swamiji in sannyas? If you say anything about 10, all right, why don't you arrange mic?